Thank you.
Thank you.
Now, a new drug is being hailed as a major breakthrough in the fight against the most common form of cancer in Australia, leukemia. The drug cured the cancer in almost a quarter of patients with advanced leukemia.
Dr. Con Tam from the Peter MacCallum Cancer Centre joins us now from Melbourne. Dr. Tam, good morning and thank you for making time.
Good morning, Virginia.
Tell me about the drug and the trial.
Okay, so the drug is called ABT-199. The trial is a phase one trial, which means it's the first time we've used this drug in humans, and it's in a type of leukemia called chronic lymphocytic leukemia.
And that's the most common type of leukemia, isn't it?
Correct. So this is the most common type of leukemia in the adults. It usually responds to chemotherapy, but invariably chemotherapy loses its effect and the leukemia becomes resistant to drug. Chemotherapy.
And so what's so particular about this drug that makes it effective?
Well, what's so special about this drug is that it is not chemotherapy at all. It is what we call a targeted drug, which means that we are specifically targeting a protein called BCL2 that the leukemia depends on to survive. So whereas chemotherapy damages all the cells in your body to cause an effect on the cancer, this drug in effect is like a sniper rifle taking out just a leukemia cell. And this drug has produced an effect in patients where all the other chemotherapy has failed.
That sounds enormously promising. I guess you need to now move to a phase two trial in order to really nail down the evidence and to prove that it might be effective.
Correct. So the evidence that we have so far is in a first in human trial.
Yep.
So this is the first time we're getting to know the drug. And already we're starting to see an effect that is much more than we expect.
And
so I just had to correct your presenter. You said that 23% of patients were cured of their leukemia.
Yes.
This is not exactly true. 23% had the leukemia cleared from the body.
Yes.
To the point where we can't detect it by conventional technology. But we think, based on current knowledge, that it will come back if we stop the drug.
Okay, so we shouldn't use the term cured, but we can say clear it from detectable levels, and then its eradication maintained by taking the drug.
Correct.
Okay, if that's the case, though, are there some uncomfortable or difficult side effects from being continually on that drug?
Well, that's what's so good about being a targeted agent. Your normal body cells do not depend on this protein for survival. So essentially, on first in human trial, we have very few side effects, and the vast majority of patients take this drug by mouth every day with essentially very minor or no side effects.
And was it an Australian development, or is this an internationally developed drug?
So it is an international trial, but it has a very important Australian story. So the Walter and Eliza Hall Medical Institute has been interested in the BCL2 protein since 1988, when the has been an integral part of developing drugs that target this protein over the past two decades. And this is really the fruit, the culmination of two decades of work resulting in a highly effective drug. And Melbourne patients are the first in the world to be able to get access to this drug, which is very important for Australian medical research.
That's just fantastic. We are huge fans of the Walter and Eliza Institute here on the program, so we're very happy to hear of that connection. So I guess it's not going to be made commercially available then, and more generally available for quite some time, and until you get through that phase two trial.
Correct. So this drug will go into what we call a phase two and a phase three trial, which means that we're going to use it in a larger group of patients, and we need to prove that this is the best drug available for these patients compared to the very best of what we have at this point in time.
And just to wrap up this morning, Doctor, if I can, is it true to say that now, when it comes to the treatment of leukemia, we very rarely do bone marrow transplants? We've now really moved into the area of dealing with it through chemo and through drug therapy, that people no longer have to go through that difficult transplant process now?
So the bone marrow transplant is still required for patients when the leukemia has become resistant to chemotherapy.
Mm.
But with these new groups of targeted agents, where we're starting to really hit the leukemia hard and keep it under long-term suppression with daily treatment, we're hoping that we can use bone marrow transplant in a less frequent manner than we had to in the past.
Dr. Kontan, we are hoping the same. So congratulations to you and your colleagues, and thanks for joining us.
Thank you for your interest.
It's just terrific, and particularly when we're talking about the era of having to develop new technologies, and if we're not to make cars anymore or not to do that kind of work, this is the area that Australia seems to be